Do subscribe to Ekeeda channel and press bell icon to get updates about latest engineering, HSE and IIT JEE main and advanced videos.
Hello students. Today we are studying chapter Chromosomal Basis of Inheritance, and in that we are studying topic Chromosomal Theory. When I say chromosomal theory, it means the number of chromosomes that are present in an individual. Chromosomal theory. Now, we all know that each one of us has 46 numbers of chromosomes inside single cell. This theory was proposed by Sutton and Bowdry. And once they proposed this theory, it's very clear today that all of us human beings are diploid. That is, we have set of chromosomes, that is, we have 23 pairs of chromosomes and one sex chromosomes. Now, there are organisms which are not diploid, and there are organisms which are haploid. When I say gametes, those are haploids, whereas living organisms, most of them are diploid. So this is chromosomal theory. All the gametes, whether it is male, female of an animal, is always haploid, whereas organisms like male, man, human beings, hen, etc. are diploid. And when I say diploid, they consist of 46 number of chromosomes. That's diploid number of chromosomes. Chromosomal theory. Now, the chromosomal theory that was given by Sutton and Bowdry was the theory that laid the basis of genetics today. They clearly stated that every organism who is dioecious, or simply I say diploid, will have diploid number of chromosomes. That is, they will have 46 number of chromosomes inside their somatic cells. Now, we all know today that there are somatic cells and then there are germ cells. So somatic cells would include your eye cells, leg cells, hand cells. Those will have total 46 number of chromosomes, that is 23 in pairs. Now, once they propose this theory, the theory is very clear. It states that gametes carry hereditary characteristics. Hereditary, when I say, something that's passed from your father to you and will be passed from you to your children, passed on from generation to generation, and is a link between the parents. For example, some characteristics you would get, that's of your father, whereas some characteristics that you have is your mother. So it's a combination of two, and offsprings usually pass these characteristics to the further generations. Now, each organism has a diploid number of chromosomes will have it in the somatic cells, whereas the haploid number of chromosomes are present in the germ cells. An organism who is diploid can also be called as dioecious in nature. Now, nucleus is the master control of the cell, but nucleus also contains your chromosomes or your genetic material, which is basically your hereditary determining characteristic. The way you look, the way your hair looks, the way your eye looks. Everything is decided on by your chromosomes, that's passed by your parents. So students, in this part of the chapter, what we came across was about the chromosomal theory. And I hope you all are very clear with this concept. Thank you.